Good afternoon, friends. You are welcome to our tutorials today. Today, we will continue from the aspect of the axilla where we stopped. In our previous video, we talked about the anterior wall of the axilla, anterior axillary wall. Today, we will be talking about the posterior wall, the medial wall, the lateral wall, and we also talk about the functions of the axilla. Let's talk about the posterior wall of the axilla. The posterior wall of the axilla is formed by some muscles. It includes the latissimus dorsi, the teres major, the subscapularis, and in some textbooks, they do add the scapula. So these form the posterior wall of the axilla. Now, just as we have anterior axillary wall and anterior axillary fold, from the previous video, we saw that those two things are not the same. In like manner, we have the posterior axillary wall and the posterior axillary fold. The posterior axillary fold is different from the posterior axillary wall. The posterior axillary fold is the inferiormost part of the posterior axillary wall. The posterior axillary fold is formed by these structures we've listed, but the posterior axillary wall is formed by just the latissimus dorsi and the teres major. Remember that point. The posterior axillary wall is formed by these structures, but the posterior axillary fold is formed by the latissimus dorsi and the teres major muscle. With that, we move to the next, which is the medial wall. The medial axillary wall is formed by the first four ribs and the muscles that are between them. So the first four ribs and the serratus anterior muscles that are located between these first four ribs is what we refer to as forming the medial wall of the axilla. The medial wall of the axilla is muscular in nature. It is not the bony wall. The lateral wall of the axilla, which is the last wall, is the only bony wall of the axilla. The lateral wall of the axilla is formed by the intertubercular sulcus of the humerus. Now, some of you may be thinking, why are these walls not called the bony walls? Why is the posterior wall not called the bony wall? It has scapula, even though there are muscles within. Why is the medial wall not called the bony wall? It has the first four ribs, even though serratus anterior muscles are also there. Simply put, it is because, since there are muscles located with these bones that you can see in the other walls, they are not completely bony. So we cannot call them the bony wall. But for the lateral wall, it has no muscle. It is formed by a bone, the humerus, specifically the intertubercular sulcus of the humerus. Since it is formed only by bony structure, it is what we refer to as the bony wall of the axilla. Maybe ask this in your exam. The axilla has four walls. Two are bony. True or false? It is false. The axilla has four walls, and one of them is bony, and that is the lateral wall, formed by the intertubercular sulcus of the humerus. After looking at the parts of the axilla, we need to discuss a little on the functions of the axilla. The functions of the axilla. The main function of the axilla is that it helps as a passageway for the transmission of structures from the neck into the upper limb. Now, there are some vessels that supply the upper limb, some arteries. There are some nerves that give innervation to the muscles of the upper limb, but they pass through the axilla in order to get to the upper limb. For example, the axillary artery is a continuation of the subclavian artery. As it enters into the axilla, it becomes the axillary artery, and in the arm, it is known as the brachial artery. Therefore, the axilla just helps as a transmission of the subclavian artery into the arm. So please just take note, one of the major functions of the axilla is that it helps as a passageway for the passing of structures, nerves, vessels, from the neck into the upper limbs. It also helps for the passage of structures from the neck into the thorax. These are the functions of the axilla. Special note: the axilla has specific content. Take this content as special note actually. The content of the axilla are simple to remember, but there's one aspect I will tell you that you should not confuse. The content of the axilla includes axillary artery and its branches, axillary veins and its tributaries, axillary group of lymph nodes, and cores of brachial plexus. Take note of this. Cores of brachial plexus. Because you may be asked this in your exam. Take note, you may ask. The trunks of brachial plexus are contents of the axilla. True or false? It is false actually. The content of the brachial of the axilla is what I've listed: axillary artery and the branches, axillary veins and the tributaries, axillary group of lymph nodes, the cords of brachial plexus. Let's give a little apply some clinical correlation on the axilla. For example, there's a structure in the axilla which we refer to as the axillary vein. It is very prominent and can easily be damaged. Therefore, sharp cuts in the axilla can damage some structures. Very important. The axillary group of lymph nodes are very important in the metastasis or spread of cancer. Tumor to these regions can cause pain in the axilla. These are some of the apply of the axilla. So in this video, we've been able to summarize what forms the posterior wall of the axilla. We've been able to summarize also what is the posterior axillary fold and what forms it. We said it is different from the posterior axillary wall. We've also seen what forms the medial wall of the axilla, what forms the lateral wall of the axilla, which is the only bony wall formed by the intertubercular surface on the humerus. We've also seen the function of the axilla, the contents of the axilla, and some applied anatomy about the axilla. This is the brief of the axilla. Thank you very much for watching this video. I please encourage you to subscribe. Subscription is free. Thank you very much and God bless you.